Hey guys, I'm Philippe from Cyberbikes, and I'm gonna show you how to shift gears on your Bafang mid-drive bike or any mid-drive e-bike you might have. On a Bafang system, it's very important to take off on the very first gear. I have a brake sensor. That means that if I press the brake lever, before I lock the wheel, I can kill the motor. So I have some room to kill the motor, but allow the wheel to continue spinning. In that gap is when I will do all the gear shifting. When we use the throttle of the Bafang system, this is like level one. Let's put maximum speed. Let's shock the society. Okay, so when you throttle your Bafang system, the chain ring has some inertia. I let the inertia pull the chain and then I shift gears. So I do like this, throttle, release the throttle, shift gears, see? And I'm not throttling, then I throttle again. Release the throttle, use the inertia, and throttle again. If I want to bring the gears back to first, because I'm going to stop the bike, I'm going to use the brake sensor. So I'm just going to press the brake sensor enough to kill the motor. Now I start wrenching the shifter, gear shifter, and pedaling with the motor killed. Wrenching, motor killed, wrenching, motor killed. Now I'm on very first gear, I completely lock the wheel, all right? So now I stop the bike, I'm on the very first gear, and I'm ready to take off again. If you keep doing this, always taking off on the first gear, you prevent damaging the internal gears of the motor. You're gonna prevent damaging the chain or snapping the chain. The cassette of gears gonna have a longer lifespan, and the maintenance you're gonna have on this bike will be replacing the gear cable. If you decide to save gears, be a bit lazy, say, I don't wanna shift that many gears, you're gonna have to replace the internal gears of the motor, the bearings of the motor, the pinion, and that's a type of work that is not maintenance, is a repair work, and that's what we want to avoid. So shift gears, replace the gear cable, save your drivetrain, and have a very reliable motor for many years. So we have shown how to shift gears using the brake cutoff, which in my opinion is the best way. Then we have some people that have the gear sensor, or some companies recommend the gear sensor to them. Why I don't like the gear sensor is, let's say you are an inexperienced rider, you are learning how to use your Bafang motor, and you have the gear sensor on your bike. So let's say you found a very nice hill and you want to climb it. As you are climbing that hill, you decide to shift one gear up. However, the gear sensor will stop the motor, so you are going to reduce the speed at the same time that you are facing a more challenging surface, which is an inclined path. So the gear sensor will end up reducing your speed because it's gonna cut the motor. You're gonna engage a higher gear, which will require more speed. However, you are reducing the speed at the same time that you are facing an inclined path. That's a combination to stall the motor, make the motor stop at the same time that you are pumping energy through the phase wires. Mate, that's an explosive combination. You might end up short-circuiting your motor, burning the controller, and coming back to the shop without understanding what happened. So that's why I don't like the gear sensor. So stay tuned, like, subscribe, follow us in all social medias, Facebook and Instagram, and I see you next time. Cheers.